lives. He would fight for what's right. He's an amazing human being. And so thank you for your Geno sweaters. That's and same when I see Dr. Boas sweater there. Terry Price, you know, I'll tell you just briefly before I answer our three esteemed hockey players here. One of the greatest lessons of this show has been the Indigenous lesson. So when we did Rogers Hometown Hockey in Niagara Falls, Tara Sloan, my co-host on that show, we had Chief Stacey LaForme, the Mississaugas of the Credit, do the welcome. And when we were done, and we went to commercial, Chief LaForme said to Tara and me, "Now listen, you two, if you ever have problems in your life, if you ever have relationship issues, whether it's at home or at work, call me. I'm really good at that." And I thought, wow, what an interesting thing to have, you know, someone say to you. I said, "How did you know?" No, but you must know, I've been through the ringer a few times in my career, whether it's Don leaving or other occasions where I've put my foot in my mouth, I always call Chief LaForme. And Stacey's the one who says to me, "No, Ron, don't say that, because you'll make them feel, you know, on the defensive, or you'll make them feel shame. You could frame it this way." And he's been an incredible guy in my life. And it's not just him. With Terry Price's mom, Linda, her great-great-great-grandfather, so one generation further than Terry, Domus Aquinas is one of the most influential leaders in our history. So I turn to the Prices. I turn to Chief Glenn Hudson of Pecos First Nation in Manitoba, to Maurice Sinclair, to Chief Wilton Littlechild in Enoch Cree Nation in Edmonton. All of them are incredible counsel to all of us at Hockey Night in Canada. No idea how great the thread. And I'll tell you one quick last story about that. Zach Whitecloud won the Stanley Cup last year for the Vegas Golden Knights. He was incredible. That pairing with Nick Hague was kind of the key to the deal. So Zach is from Sioux Valley, Dakota Nation in Manitoba. There's another great athlete from the same nation. Her name was Angela Chalmers. 30 years ago, I was here in Victoria for the Commonwealth Games. And Tom LaFortune did the totem pole for us, and we had a beautiful welcome ceremony, much like Cecilia's arranging the canoe entrance at Protocol Point this weekend. So Tom graced us with his brilliance as an artist. All we have in the end is our story. And Tom gave us your story then. And then I was to interview Angela Chalmers, who was a favorite to win gold in the 3,000-meter race. So I set up a camera with the help of my colleague and a light over in the stands at the stadium. And I said, "Angela, if I could just have 3 minutes, you know, this was 2 days before the race." And Angela said, "Oh, Ron, why don't we just move down in the grass? It's where I'm more comfortable." So we went into the infield and did the interview there, and she was magic. And then she won the 3,000 meters 2 days later, probably the highlight of the games. The crowd was going berserk as she came. I get emotional just thinking. So then the next year, I'm in Gothenburg, Sweden, for the World Track and Field Championships, and I had Donovan Bailey to interview, and Donovan's emerging as a great Canadian track star. And I thought, I'm gonna interview Donovan in the grass in the infield and see how that goes, and he was incredible. It taught me that the land, you know, is where we belong, and if you're in touch with it, everything goes so much better. So it's a lesson I learned here in Victoria from Angela Chalmers from our First Nation. So I thank you for that. See, I was emotional from where that came from. Alex Nelson. Alexander Nelson, get up here. I'll introduce you one by one. Our goaltender for Friday night's alumni game. Obviously, a hero of alumni for the National Indigenous Games. And a great Canadian elite goaltender. So, and a great box lacrosse player, too. Well, I'll just ask you your question right now, Alex. Why don't you tell the kids and our elders and everyone your story?
Hi, so I'm Alex Nelson, as Ron said. My story, you know, starts in, with like female hockey. Started a few years, like first year TV. I was got contacted by a great coach, Mike Bray. He just revitalized the North Island Impact female team, which is now the league that, you know, I think some of the young female players know is the Victoria Reign now. So I started there, played there for about four-ish years, and then, you know, got an amazing opportunity to go and play for Shawnee Lake School, which is a really good team in the Canadian School Sports Hockey League. You know, if it wasn't for, like, a lot of the coaches and the mentors that I've had over the years, especially, like, Mike Bray and Carly Haggard, who's my current coach now, I probably wouldn't be as far as I am. And of course, thanks to iSpark, I've been part of the National Hockey Championships for TBC, and then this summer I got to represent BC with the North American Indigenous Games in lacrosse. So I thought that's like a huge honor for me, and I'm so grateful for everybody that has helped me throughout the years. So.
Thank you.